When Captain America throws his mighty shield, all those who chose to oppose his shield must yield. If he's led to a fight and a duel is due, then the red and the white and the blue will come through when Captain America throws his mighty shield.
Welcome, friends, Asgardians, Venusians, to another episode of Be Kind, Rewind. This is your Disney movie podcast. I, of course, am Dan Teets. And we are covering the seventh episode of the Marvel Disney Plus original What If. This episode was entitled, What If Thor Were an Only Child? And the synopsis, which is care of Wikipedia, goes a little something like this. After defeating the Frost Giants, Odin discovers the abandoned infant Loki and returns him to life. Years later, Odin's son, Thor, try saying that three, has become a boisterous, party-loving prince. While Odin sleeps and Frigga is away, Thor travels to Earth to host a rave party with aliens from all over the galaxy. His arrival attracts the attention of Jane Foster and Darcy, who end up joining the party. As Thor and Foster grow close, acting S.H.I.E.L.D. director Maria Hill summons Carol Danvers, aka Captain Marvel, to end the destruction caused by Thor's antics. Danvers confronts Thor, but is unable to defeat him without exerting her full power. So Lewis and Hill suggest she take the fight to a less populated area. To avoid this, Jane Foster confronts Frigga with Heimdall's help as Hill readies a nuclear strike while Danvers and Thor begin to throw down, but Frigga interrupts them and announces her arrival. Frightened, Thor and all the partygoers clean up the mess, and after all this has gone on, Foster prompts Thor to ask her out on a date, but an army of drones led by Ultron in Vision's body and wielding all six Infinity Stones appears. Now, I do have to admit, when Ultron showed up, I did not recognize him. And that is not from lack of knowing Marvel. I didn't recognize him because he was only on the screen for about maybe 10 seconds, if that. And the fact that he had the Infinity Stones kind of threw me off as well. So, honestly, I thought it was Thanos just wearing some kind of new battle armor. But that is just me. So, this was definitely a different take on the what-if analogy. Because you didn't have Loki kind of centering Thor. Because with Loki in the picture, he kept Thor from running off. Because he was always doing his own mischievous antics. And it kind of kept Thor centered. But, I mean, it was good. The fight sequences were definitely on par for Marvel. And the fact that they actually brought in Captain Marvel for the extended portion of the show actually was on point. I did like the fact that instead of Loki actually being Thor's height, he was some 12-foot tall Frost Giant, which I definitely didn't expect. I thought when Loki was going to walk on, he was going to be as normal, however tall he is in the Marvel universe. So that was kind of cool. The pranks and the antics that they all put together was actually funny, especially with Thor straightening up the Leaning Tower of Pisa and actually putting it back to how it was before it started to sink into the earth. And this was kind of a, I don't know if it was an homage to what Superman actually did when he was, I think it was Superman 3, where he fought himself. Yeah, it was Superman 3 because it was Richard Pryor, which is the one that not everybody likes, but I kind of like it because you actually get to see Superman fight a mirror match. Now, I'm totally down for mirror match, as you know from listening to other episodes of this, especially the Sinister Strange Supreme. So, I mean, this one was straight and to the point. The fact that they got the mom involved kind of was, it showed how juvenile Thor actually was, and that he was afraid of his mom and what she was actually going to do to him. So it kind of had me laughing when she showed up right as Maria was getting ready to launch the nukes. But all in all, it was a good episode. It was definitely not the best episode of the series. That would still have to be the zombie episode, which, from what I'm reading, they are making a live-action version, or they've started talks on how to actually make a live-action Marvel Zombies movie. And the day that that comes, I will be sitting fifth row center at the movie theaters, provided that movie theaters are still. Because, I mean, you're going to have, it's going to have all the actual Marvel people in it, as far as I could tell. And, of course, it'll be CG for the zombies. So it's not like you're actually going to have Chris Evans and Robert Downey Jr. actually playing themselves. They can actually just zombify them and throw them in there. So I'm kind of looking forward to that. I'd like to know what y'all think about it. What y'all think about the series as a whole. I do see that we are getting some new listeners, and I'd like to thank y'all for tuning in. Because, I mean, y'all do have other things that you could be doing with your time. So, once again, thank you for tuning in. If this is your first episode with us, welcome. If this is your second episode with us, drop me a line, bekindrewinddmp@gmail.com. Once again, the DMP stands for Disney Movie Podcast. Or just drop us a review on whatever streaming service it is that you're listening to us on. And then send me an email letting me know that you've done that, so that way I can go check it out. And who knows, we may actually read your review on the air once we get back to normal movie reviewing. I have actually got some great things lined up once we get through this series, which will be 2 weeks. Yeah, we're down to the last 2 weeks, I think, because it's a 9-week season. So we've got that to look forward to. So for those of you who came for What If, stick around. This is going to go back to what it was prior, which is a Disney movie podcast. Hence the name, Be Kind Rewind, your Disney movie podcast. I have rattled on enough, so I'm going to sign off tonight. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time it is that you're listening to us. Thank you for tuning in. Come back next week. And until then, stay safe, stay hungry, and watch out for Thor's Mjolnir. Good night, everybody. Thank you for listening to this podcast. If you would like to send us an email, you can do so at bekindrewinddmp@gmail.com. DMP stands for Disney Movie Podcast. Once again, thank you for listening, and have a wonderful day.
No, there's a Midgardian word for women like you. Party pooper! There, I said it!